It may look like a flight simulator, but the Ford logo gives away that inside this dome at the company's Dearborn, Michigan headquarters is not the cockpit of an airplane, but a full-sized car. Called the Virtual Test Track Experiment, or VIRTTEX Lab, the $10 million facility allows Ford to study the interaction between a car and its driver. The company claims it's the only one of its kind in the U.S. and sees a big benefit from simulating real-world driving forces.
If we just have that visual sensation, people start steering, and at a minimum, they feel like they're on ice. Usually what happens is they oversteer, and then they overcompensate. So you start getting this oscillating steering behavior without motion. And as you increase more and more motion, what we call motion scale, once you get up to like 50, 70%, somewhere in there, people's lane keeping performance and lane change behavior actually matches on-road performance quite well.
Ford has used VIRTTEX to test distracted drivers and have simulated that by asking drivers to read numbers while driving. They've also done tests on drowsy drivers. The dome is 24 feet in diameter and made of carbon fiber. It has 5 CRT projectors to simulate the road and even a display mounted in the car's back seat for the rearview mirror. When drivers are in the simulator, Ford pumps in real-world audio to make it feel even more like the real thing.
This is, again, we're using gaming industry to replicate the 3D sound. We use that type of software. We put our additional specific software and sounds on top of it. So getting recorded wind noise, engine noise, road noise. If you kind of see back here, this is what's called a binaural head. We can actually put that in a vehicle, go and make actual vehicle recordings. The microphones are in the ears. So you actually get sounds recorded that are representative of what you would hear in an actual vehicle. We can bring those recordings onto this device, play it through this gaming engine, if you will. It goes through a bunch of equalizers here that equalize the vehicle buck or cabin out there so that when the sounds are played back, it sounds like an actual vehicle for wind noise, engine noise, powertrain noise. The computer here, this is what is running all of our real-time vehicle models, this scenario code that I call kind of the controlling the ballet of vehicles. It's a dual quad-core CPU technology.
He wasn't sure of the processing power, but thought it was around 2.3 gigahertz for each of the 8 cores. Next to it is Ford's image generator from Quantum 3D. When someone steps into the simulator, all of the systems come into play to create a driving scenario that's both realistic and safe for everyone involved. Reporting from Dearborn, Michigan, I'm Nick Barber, IDG News Service.